गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी, आई एम मनोज कुमार नागर, आई एम गिविंग प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ एडोब पेज मेकर. वॉट इज पेज मेकर 6.5? दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्क्रीन विच इज शोन ऑन एडोब पेज मेकर 6.5. पेज मेकर इज ए पेज लेआउट एप्लीकेशन. पेज मेकर इज एक्सटेंशन. पेज मेकर यूज टू काइंड ऑफ एक्सटेंशन, पेज मेकर 65 एंड टेम्पलेट फाइल्स T65. This dialog box allows you to create defaults for how PageMaker will treat the content in your application. Zero text, save your files, move items, measure items, and display guides. Working environment of PageMaker, in which we can see a display window, new publication window, blank pages, a master page, and current page icons, horizontal and vertical scroll bars, rulers can be adjusted in inches and centimeters, the control palette, the toolbox, and other palettes. The PageMaker toolbox, which enables for typing fonts. Basic tools are used here for drawing various shapes. Color palette is used to make quick color changes to your publication. By default, every color's palette must contain the following colors: none, paper, playback, and registration. The control palette gives a one-stop shop, enabling you to change several formatting options in one place rather than making repeat trips to the type menu. Ruler guides can be on and off, as well as rulers can be adjusted with the short key control plus R, the key combination on which it can be adjusted on inches as well as centimeters. This is the way how we can create a document in Adobe PageMaker. First, click on the file menu, then click on new. Create a new document allows us to set up with publication page with specified settings. Then define such things as the size of the page, size of the margins, and even the orientation of the page. The master page typically contains the basic page design elements of a page, such as headers and footers and page numbers. Save and save as commands allow you to store your active publication. To save your publication, choose file, save, or press the control plus key combination. The open command allows you to open a previously saved publication. To open a publication, choose file. Control plus O is the short key combination to open a file. Click on file menu and click on close, or press control plus W to close the active publication. These are the basic tools. The pointer tool is used to select, move, and resize text, objects, and graphics. Text tool is used to create text and text frames, select and edit text. The rotation tool is used to select and rotate text, objects, and graphics. The cropping tool is used to crop parts of the graphics that you do not want to print. Drawing tools allow you to create simple graphics or frames to hold text, or imported graphics to which we can apply a short and or fill. Visual tools allow you to zoom in and zoom out of or navigate around your publication or pasteboard. These tools can be used on their own or in conjunction with other tools by using the keyboard shortcut. Double clicking some of the tools will display various dialog boxes. We can create custom colors using the define colors dialog box. To open the define color dialog box, choose utilities, define colors. To select a color or choose a color model such as RGB, red, green, blue, go to the color option dialog box. Choosing utilities, define color and clicking the new buttons, we can set the percentage for cyan, magenta, yellow, black. Default is cyan. Type process model CMYK. There are various other models also available in the colors options dialog. Color palette has the fill button, stroke button. Styles and colors are the two tabs given on this palette. Both button color icons are there for various colors. CMS color model and ink value tint, drop down list, color model icon, color type icon, trash icon, green. Blocks versus a text block is one of two ways in which PageMaker allows you to add text to your publication. A frame becomes a text frame or graphics depending on the content you want to add into it. To input into a text block, the quick brown fox jumps over the ladies' block. This sentence contains all the 26 alphabets of English language. To input text into a text frame, these are the various boxes which show these options. Placing the place dialog box allows you to import text from various sources. PageMaker can import such files as spreadsheet or database documents, word processed documents and other PageMaker story files, American standard code for information in text files, RTA for rich text files, and hypertext markup language files. Editing text. To edit a text, first we need to highlight text in a text frame or text blocks with the mouse and delete existing text or add a new text in this. There are various shortcuts to change font color, font size. Text control palette. In the character view, click one of the font options in the control palette. Using the toggling buttons, choose the type, style, case, position, type, size. Leading expert tracking, horizontal scale kerning, and baseline shift to format the text. Character specifications dialog box. The character specification dialog box to format the text in the publication. If you open the dialog box without having any text selected, any changes you will make becomes default setting you will see using your publication. Placing pictures. The place dialog box helps us to import graphics of files format such as TIFF, EPS, JPG, and GIF is graphical image filter, joint picture export group is JPG, tagged file image file filter is TIFF. The control palette allows us to adjust the size of your picture, location of the picture on the page, the size of your picture frame, the rotation of the picture, or how the picture is skewed. This is the way feature can be modified. Cropping an image. When you import a graphic from another program or publication, we can crop part of the graphic that we want to print by adjusting the size of its surrounding bounding box. Selecting objects. Using the pointer tool, we can select various objects. We can select a single object. We can select multiple objects and modifying them. Or when by using various keys like Control, Shift, you can select multiple objects. Grouped objects, when selected, appears with four handles at the corners that define the bounding box of all objects in the group. The mouse places the pointer over the object we would like to move and select it. Click and drag the object to the new desired location. The object has now been moved. With the Align Objects dialog box, we can align objects in relation to one another and or even distribute the spaces between the objects. The Send to Back command will move selected objects to the back level of any overlapping objects. The Bring to Fore command will move selected objects to the front level of any overlapping objects. When we are ready to print our publication, go to File, click on Print to open the Print Document dialog box. Print Document display settings that will allow you to set up various output options. This is the dialog, Print dialog. Then we can print on various sizes of paper. This is the print paper area. These are the print options. Print color dialog box also there for taking color grayscale, print colors in black. Print pitches are also dot per inch to set 720, 72 dpi, 144 dpi, 300, 600. Any questions? Please contact on my mobile number for any questions and details.